Carmen.
No way. Mark Hamill. Yeah. All right, we're looking good. I have a sound check. They got bars coming across. All right, shoot away. Thank you again, sir.
You bet, Mark.
All right.
All right, ready?
Yep.
Mark
Gross here, Baltimore NostalgiaCon 2016, with the good-looking, the tall, the famous, the man about town this weekend, Mr. Where? Robert Fuller. Hey. It's
oh.
you.
Oh,
Robert
Mark.
Fuller, how you doing, brother? You look wonderful.
Well, thank you, pal. I'm still fooling him.
You're still fooling him.
You bet.
So you're not really this tall. It's just I'm really this short. Sir, you have got such a great fan club. You've such a great career. You've done so much. Your fans are amazing. I mean, for 3 days here at this NostalgiaCon, the lines wrapped around the building. It's wonderful. My first question would be, how did you begin your career in acting? What really got you involved, sir?
You know, I never really dreamt or thought about becoming an actor.
Yes, sir.
I got into the Screen Extras Guild just for the money.
Wow.
I was the doorman at Grumman's Chinese Theater on Hollywood Boulevard.
That's amazing.
Making 35 cents an hour.
Oh, my goodness.
And I guess I was about 18 years old. And I met a whole bunch of kids around my age that were in the Screen Extras Guild.
Yes,
and they'd come to the movies.
Yes,
and,
sir.
They kept saying to me, come on, you ought to get in the Screen Extras Guild with us. We make $12.05 a day, plus overtime, meal penalties. You could make 25 bucks, or, you know. So
wow.
I went down and I joined the Screen Extras Guild.
Yes, sir.
Had no idea about being an actor or anything, but I probably worked in over 100 movies as an extra, just
yes.
walking around in the background, you know, whatever
yes,
you do. And then I got, the Korean War was on, and I finally turned 19 and got drafted and went to Korea and spent 17 months over there. And then when I came back, my very, very best friend was an actor named Chuck Courtney, who played Dan Reed on the Lone Ranger television series.
Yes, sir.
And he had started in an acting class with Richard Boone.
Right.
Now, Dick Boone had just done a series called Medic, which I didn't see because
yes,
I was overseas.
Yes, sir.
And they convinced me to go to class, and I did. And I met Dick, and Dick thought I had a shot at being an actor. So he said, I want you to study with me.
Wonderful.
And I said, what the heck, I'll give it a shot.
Wonderful.
And I did, and he liked what I did in class. He sent me back to New York to study with Sandy Meisner at the Neighborhood Playhouse,
sure.
Which I did, which he graduated from. And sooner or later, I started getting some small parts, and they got bigger and bigger. And then by 1959, they offered me Laramie, which was amazing.
Fantastic.
You know? Yeah.
Oh, my God. Now, that ran how long, sir?
That was 5 seasons.
Yeah, yeah, very good.
128 episodes.
A lot of episodes,
like
yeah, for sure.
And then I went right into Wagon Train after that.
Yes, sir.
And then after Wagon Train, I did several motion pictures, my favorite one being The Return of the Magnificent Seven with Yul Brynner.
That was a wonderful movie. I loved that film.
Had a great time with
him. How was it working with them? Pretty good?
Absolutely.
Yes, sir.
Yul was magnificent.
Good.
He was the king. There's no doubt about it, believe me. But then shortly after that, Jack Webb, I was always looking to do Westerns because I happen to like the
yeah,
Westerns.
Very good interest
very
for you.
Used to that lifestyle.
Yes, sir.
But Jack wanted me to play a doctor, Jack Webb did, and I didn't want to. I'd never met him before, and I told my agent, I don't want to do a medical series, and he said, you don't understand. He says, Jack Webb wants you and nobody else to play Dr. Brackett in this new television series
right.
called Emergency.
Wow.
So I said, well, I don't want to do it, but I owe the man the courtesy to go in and tell him I don't want to do his
live and in person,
show. Absolutely. So they said, well, they're expecting you at his office after work, 7 o'clock tonight, to meet everybody. And I said, okay. So I showed up and walked into his office, and the whole Universal brass were there, and he's behind his
Holy
desk. And
cow.
Everybody's having cocktails. It's way after hours. And like an idiot, I walked up to his desk, and I said, Mr. Webb, I just... thank you for seeing me, but I just want to tell you I'm really not interested in doing a medical series. And he looked up at me and he said, shut up and sit down. I swear.
He said that to
and
you.
I took me back for a moment and he said, do you drink? And I said, yeah. He says, go fix yourself a drink and come back and sit down. Honest to God's true story.
That's wonderful.
He had a bar there, and everybody was having a cocktail. I went over and made a big drink. And I came back and sat down, and I swear, 2 hours later, I walked out of his office, having signed to do an 8-year television series with a 2-hour world premiere to start with 13 episodes sold.
Impressive. We watched it. Loved it.
I'm telling you, unbelievable.
Loved it.
But what an idiot. I don't want to do your series.
Right. But it was a choice that you made that it was destined to be you.
It was.
It was destined to be you.
And he and I became very, very good friends.
Good.
He was a marvelous man.
Good.
Yeah.
Who were some of the people you would say in Hollywood, I don't like to use that term, but classic Hollywood that you've worked with that you've really admired working with? Or,
well,
they worked with you. They admired you. But who do you
admire? It's the other way around. Trust me. I was so lucky to work with some fabulous people. Dan Duryea,
yes.
Great, fabulous actor.
Yes,
did
sir.
Several Laramies. John McIntyre, who I finally wound up doing Wagon Train
right.
with after Laramie, did several Laramies. And
yes, sir.
He was a very, very good friend. And I was very
yes,
impressed with him.
Good.
But again, I have to go back to the king.
Right.
Brenner. Something. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was great to
Wonderful.
Work with. Yeah.
What would you say is one of your favorite roles that you've done yourself personally? What do you think?
Well,
is
it has to be Laramie.
Okay.
Part of Jess Harper was
yes.
a fan. That's why that line is out there.
Yes, indeed.
It really is.
Yes, indeed.
Mostly Laramie and Wagon Train.
Fantastic.
And some of Emergency.
Right on.
But
if
these are Western fans.
Yeah. Well, and they know you from that best.
Yeah,
I mean, that's
yeah.
what you've molded the Western critique and everything.
Well,
so.
I lived it. I enjoyed
yes,
it.
Yes, sir.
And I was that part was written for me.
Good,
no
I
doubt
think
about
so.
It.
Yes,
know?
Sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. Because of the way things transpired for you at a younger age and getting into the Screen Actors Guild and all that, if there was another career you would have taken without that, what would you have done if you weren't an actor?
I would have loved to have been a game warden.
Wow.
Because I love animals and
good for you.
Yeah, and I would have. That was in my mind early on. I
yes,
didn't
sir.
Have any education. I quit school. In the ninth grade. Actually, I didn't quit. They quit me. But,
understood.
Yeah,
nowadays,
okay,
right
yeah,
now.
You got
same
the
way
message,
now.
Right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
But that's something that I really enjoyed, and I do a lot of fishing, and I used to hunt quite a bit. I don't anymore. It's somebody else's turn.
Yes.
So, but I do a lot of fishing.
Good.
And,
good deal.
Yeah.
Fantastic. For you, coming out to conventions, this is not your first convention.
No.
This is not your first rodeo.
It definitely isn't.
And to coin a phrase.
I have so much fun on these
good,
things.
Good. That's what I was going to ask.
Well, I love
the fans.
The fans
love you.
Well, I have a personal fandom, and my friend Tony Gill, of course, is
right there back behind
there
us.
Is Tony runs my website. He runs the fandom, which we have over 600 members.
I was going to say about 600,000,
because
at least 2,000 were here just today.
But
thousands.
But not only that, Tony is my dear friend.
Good.
We've been friends for many, many years. Tony's from England.
Right on.
And I like to shoot a lot.
Yes,
trap,
sir.
Mesquite, and handguns.
Fantastic.
And Tony, of course, living in England, doesn't get a chance to do that. You can't have a gun over
Broke
there.
Broke him in, didn't you?
Well, he's a wannabe cowboy. In fact, he's staying at my ranch with me right now.
Outstanding.
And rides my horse 3-4 times a day.
Oh, my God.
And then we go out and we shoot our 9mm and we shoot shotguns.
Fantastic.
And then when he gets really wild, he wants to shoot my .44 Magnum.
Can he handle that?
Oh, he's good. Oh, he's getting good.
I mean, you can handle that.
Oh, listen.
That's a cannon to me.
It's a cannon, the .44 Smith & Wesson. You have 5 shots out of it in your hand.
Yes, sir.
Like this, but I've seen him go 50 rounds.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
You never know about those guys from England.
Yeah,
huh?
You bet.
Now, you do have horses and you run. Tell me about some of the animals that you have and that you've owned and just getting out there. Do
well,
you show as well or just ride?
No, I don't. My wife does a little bit sometimes.
Okay.
She does dressage.
Yes, sir.
But both the horses on Laramie and Wagon Train were mine.
Wow.
And I wouldn't have it any other way.
Good. Good
know.
For you.
Yeah, I have one of the best picture horses in the world.
Good
my
deal.
Horse Hoot on Laramie.
Yes, sir.
And I have 2 horses now. I have my horse. My wife has hers. We've got 2 miniature donkeys.
Fantastic.
2 cats, a dog.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
and some skunks. I live out in the country.
Hopefully they don't visit as much as
oh,
the other.
Oh, they do.
Now for you when you're
he
going
he throws
up,
rocks at him.
No, come on.
He did.
You got that 44 mag, you're throwing rocks?
He took a walk with my dog one day and came back and he said he saw a skunk and actually threw a rock at it. I said, you are crazy.
He is crazy. Oh my God. I used to work construction years ago and there was a few on site and we were the first crew in to dig for the pipe. And the guys on the crew were like, look what we found. I said, don't get near him, man.
Oh, you bet.
Unbelievable. So will you continue to do, your fandom is grand and it's growing. Will you continue to come out and do shows and meet your fans? And, you know, I know you have a lot of time between all the things that you do, but you enjoy it enough you'll keep coming out and signing shows?
Well, let's see. I'm booked right now for the Williamsburg Film Festival in Williamsburg, Virginia in March.
Good.
Then I'm doing the Memphis Film Festival in June.
Wow.
Which will probably be my 12th time
in a
row for it.
Yes, sir.
So I try to do 2 to 3 of these a year.
Good deal. Wonderful.
Well, sometimes 4.
Yeah, that's good, though. The fans are out there.
Well, and they all come to them. I have fans that come from Japan and England. And
why
Germany.
Is it that 99% of them are all gorgeous women out there? That's what I'm wondering. How do I get involved with that? I can pretend I'm Richard Dreyfuss, but I'm not tall, dark, and handsome, so...
Listen, Dreyfuss is all right. You come on and hang out with me for a while. You get some of those kisses I'm getting.
You heard it here first. Hey, I'm hanging.
I'll share with you. Come on.
Yeah, he's got too many now, I'll tell you. Thousands. Sir, you've been wonderful here. We love seeing you. One more question is, you see a lot of celebrities while you come out to shows because there's a lot to come out to shows with you. For you, actually two questions. Are you a collector of anything? Do you collect anything? Bric-a-brac, anything? Anything that interests you as a collection?
Guns.
Outstanding.
A person can never have too many guns.
Yes, sir. Well put. And if you, yourself, could get an autograph from somebody that maybe you have never been able to do, who would you say you'd want an autograph from?
Winston Churchill.
Fantastic. Why? Why would that be?
I think he was one of the most incredible men ever hit this planet.
Outstanding.
Yeah.
Good for you. Anything you'd like to tell some of your fans that are watching this right now?
Well, just like to say hi to everybody, and if you get a chance, come on out to Williamsburg or come to the Memphis Film Festival sometime. We'll be happy to say hi, take a picture,
fantastic,
and shake your hand.
Outstanding. Ladies and gentlemen, the tall, the good-looking, the very cool Mr. Robert Fuller.
Mark,
thank you, brother. Wonderful interview,
sir.
That's
an awful big build-up there, pal. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I'm going to have you hang around with me a bunch. You're going to keep that dialogue up.
As long as I get kissed on the head, I'm okay. NostalgiaCon 2016, Robert Fuller. And we're out. Good job.
Hey, you too.
Would you, sir, sign a couple things on camera I brought with me so we can hold up? Because I also write for Sci-Fi Pulse and Autograph Magazine.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Do you have a Sharpie with you?
Oh, shoot.
That's okay. Can you run to his table and get a Sharpie?
Yeah. I'm sorry.
That's okay. Thank you, Sarah.
You're
doing
the joint,
and
right.
Then we'll take you right back.
Yeah,
Terry
will get the table.
But she'll take it right back for you, too. But this is, you're fantastic. We could not believe when we came in the crowds that are here for you. And honest to God, we thought they didn't know where to line up for each guest. And everybody was saying, no, that's Robert Fuller's fans. I went, wow, unbelievable. That's impressive. That's got to feel great.
I came down yesterday morning around 10, and you weren't scheduled for around 10. And I told him, I said, you know, it's 10 o'clock.